In this training video film module on diesel electric locomotives, we will show you the checkpoints of incoming examination, the prescribed A, B and C maintenance schedules of engine and its related components, and the prescribed A, B and C schedules of the expressor. The incoming examination of the diesel locomotive is done before every schedule. The A schedule is done after every 10 days, B schedule after every month, and the C schedule is done after every 3 months. The A schedule will include all the checks carried out in the incoming examination plus the prescribed A schedule items. Similarly, B schedule will include the A schedule plus the prescribed B schedule items, and the C schedule will include B schedule plus the prescribed C schedule items. As soon as a diesel locomotive returns to the base depot after a trip, take it to the maintenance shed for its schedule. Before beginning the schedule, the concerned supervisor should examine the driver's repair book for any bookings made during the trip by the driver. Attend to these repairs during the scheduling. After this, the lab staff should collect samples of lube oil from the lube oil dipstick hole and the water sample from the water expansion tank filling cap and conduct appropriate examination. After this, place the locomotive at the cleaning point. Shut down the locomotive and clean the locomotive with a wash. Also wash the locomotive thoroughly from the outside with a soap solution. Now air blow the radiator. Blow the air jet from inside the radiator so that the air pressure from the inside can easily blow off the dust particles on the radiator fins. After cleaning the locomotive, now place the loco on the pit. Start the locomotive and keep it at idle. The lube oil pressure on idle should not be less than 2.5 kg per centimeter square. The fuel oil pressure at idle should be 3.5 kg per centimeter square. Then visually inspect the locomotive for any visible defect, cracked or broken components. Check for any missing component, nuts and bolts. Check for any leaking joints, seals, pipes, etc. Check the cylinder head, manifolds and joints for blows and leaks. After this examination, check and record the following pressures. Insert the vacuum gauge at the expressor lube oil filling adapter on the breather valve assembly in the expressor and record the readings. The difference between the expressor crankcase vacuum and the expressor train pipe vacuum should not be more than 12.5 centimeters of mercury. Now insert the expressor lube oil pressure gauge at the gauge pipe adapter in the efficiency needle valve assembly. The recommended expressor lube oil pressure on idle at any temperature should not be less than 1.8 kg per centimeter square. Now visually inspect the air brake and the vacuum brake system. The expressor loading should be at 8 kg per centimeter square and the expressor unloading should be at 10 kg per centimeter square. Next, put the 8 mm test plate on both the ends of the vacuum hose pipe and take the reading. The vacuum gauge readings should not be less than 53 centimeters of mercury with test plate of 8 millimeters and 56 centimeters of vacuum on dummy. Always ensure that the brake cylinder pressure should be 2.5 kg per centimeter square. The control air pressure should be 5 kg per centimeter square. HS4 valve pressure should be 1.4 kg per centimeter square to 1.7 kg per centimeter square in order to maintain 560 mm vacuum on dummy. The brake pipe pressure and the equalizing reservoir pressure is adjusted to 5 kg per centimeter square with the adjusting knob of A9 valve. Check the feed valve. The setting of the feed valve should be 6 kg per centimeter square. Apply the A9 brake valve. If independent brake pressure builds in the brake cylinder pipe to 2.5 kg per centimeter square, the vacuum in train pipe drops to zero. It means that the air brakes and the vacuum brakes are synchronized. Check the cycle timing of air dryer for purging. It should be 60 seconds. Now visually examine the undergear system for any air leakage. Open the MR drain cock and drain the condensate from the cock. Check the working of auto drain valve during loading unloading of expressor. Check the working operation of the bogie cutout cock by both closing and opening the cutout cock. Physically examine the axle box for any signs of overheating. The nuts, bolts, pipe plugs, and other parts should be properly secured. Check the brake cylinder piston travel. The brake piston cylinder travel should be 2 5 by 8 to 3 inches. Let us now check the turbo rundown. Bring the locomotive to the fourth notch and warm it up to its normal working temperature. Shut down the engine by putting the OST in trip position and check the turbo rundown by a stopwatch. Compare it with the manufacturer's recommendation. If the turbo rundown is below the recommended level, arrange to send the turbo for overhaul. the defects detected during the incoming examination should be entered in the schedule form and rectified during scheduling. In engine and its related components, we will talk about the A, B and C schedules of the fuel injection system, the crankcase, cylinder head and its related items, lube oil system, turbo supercharger, exhaust manifold, and the torquing schedule. In the A schedule of the fuel injection system, clean the fuel injection pump racks, the external linkages and the connections with a clean lintless cloth. Then lubricate the fuel injection pump racks and the external linkages with lubricating oil using a spray gun. In the B schedule of the fuel injection system, observe the uniformity of all the fuel injection pump rack setting in the engine shutdown position. In case of Woodward governor, all the racks should indicate 2 to 3 millimeters. If all the racks do not indicate the reading of 2 to 3 millimeters, adjust the fuel racks by adjusting the adjusting screw. Now, check all the linkages for lost motion. In the C schedule of fuel injection system, disconnect the governor control linkages and check whether the racks, linkages and the control shaft are moving freely. If they have got stuck, apply lubricating oil and make the linkages and racks free. If the movement is still not free, visually inspect to check if there is any bending in the linkages. If so, take appropriate action. In the B schedule, engine crankcase scheduling is a crucial examination and should only be performed by highly skilled and experienced maintenance personnel. Open the engine crankcase cover and examine the engine sump visually. Is the lube oil level above the strainer? If it is, then drain out the extra lube oil by opening this dummy plug. Now examine the sump carefully. Is there any foreign material in the sump, like broken parts from any liner, connecting rod bolts, split pins, etc.? If there are, then remove the foreign material. Visually trace the source of broken parts in the engine and take appropriate action. Next, examine the lube oil header, S-pipe and its adapter nut. If the S-pipe is found loose, take appropriate action. Next, tap the nuts and bolts of the connecting rod and the main bearings with a nylon hammer. If the nuts and bolts of the connecting rod and the main bearing are found loose, take appropriate action. Now examine the connecting rod bolts and the main bearing studs. All the split pins should be present and properly locked. Check the free movement of the connecting rods. If the movement of the connecting rods is not free, take appropriate action. After the crankcase sump examination, top up the sump with lube oil. In the B schedule of cylinder head and related items, check the valve lever mechanism of the cylinder head. Remove the tappet cover of the cylinder head and visually examine the valve lever mechanism and its shaft, the valve lever equalizing yoke, and the valve springs for any damage or breakage. If there is any damage or breakage in any of these parts, replace the damaged part. For this, open all the four cap bolts of the mechanism with an Allen key. Take out the valve lever mechanism. Remove the yoke and the valve springs, whichever is damaged. Replace the damaged spring with a new spring. And the damaged yoke with a new yoke. Now, examine visually the push rods. If any push rod is damaged or bent, replace the damaged or bent push rod with a new one. Put the valve lever mechanism back. Tighten all the cap bolts properly. Also ensure proper lubrication in the valve lever mechanism. In the C schedule of the cylinder head and related items, check the tappet clearance of all the cylinder heads. For this, carry out tappet phasing of the fuel injection pumps according to the firing order and check tappet clearance of the corresponding cylinder head. For each cylinder head in the locomotive, there is a phasing point fixed on the alternator fan marked. And for each cylinder head, there is a separate fuel injection pump. So, in a 16 cylinder locomotive, there are 16 fuel injection pumps. Each fuel injection pump has two markers. One, on the outside of the fuel injection pump, is a fixed indicator showing the recommended and predetermined injection timing of the FIP. On the inside of the FIP is a movable indicator called the guide cup. When this guide cup matches with the fixed indicator, it indicates the actual injection timing setting of the FIP. The procedure of adjusting the FIP timing is as follows. Lock the cranking handle with the groove of the engine alternator fan. Ensure that the locking is proper and there is no slip. If there is any slip, it can cause injury to the personnel. Now bring the alternator fan facing points to the injection point marked INJ on the pointer. Check the corresponding FIP timing on the guide cup. If the markers on the inspection window and the guide cup do not coincide, adjust the FIP guide cup by the adjusting screw. After adjusting with the adjusting screw, lock the lock nut. Now, using the cranking handle, bring the alternator fan facing points to the TDC marked on the pointer. Now check and adjust the tappet clearance of the corresponding cylinder head valve to 34 thou. Apply the filler gauge to the gap between the cylinder head valves and its yoke. Ensure that a maximum of 2 strips of total value 34 thou is applied. If more than 2 strips are applied, the chances of error increases. The filler gauge should exactly fit in the gap. There should be no play between the filler gauge and the gap. Then use the adjusting screw of the yoke to adjust the gap between the yoke and the valve stem surface to 34 thou. Ensure that the valves on the push rod side are adjusted first and the valves on the other side are adjusted next. Carry out the blow-by test for combustion chamber of each cylinder head when the piston is at top dead center. Connect the blow-by test equipment to the decompression plug of the cylinder head. kg/cm² of constant pressure is given to the cylinder head. Pressure inside the cylinder head should not be less than 2.5 kg/cm². If it is less than 2.5 kg/cm², detect the source of leakage and recommend repairs. In the B schedule of the lube oil system, clean the lube oil stainer, its shell and renew its gasket. Open the lube oil stainer cover. Take out the stainer element. Remove the old top cover gasket and the bottom cover gasket and refit with a new one. Now refit a cleaned stainer element. Ensure that the lube oil stainer element is not damaged. If it is damaged, change the lube oil stainer element. Now put back the stainer element into the housing. Change the lube oil stainer cover gasket and tighten the cover properly. In the B schedule of lube oil system, also renew the filter elements and the O-ring of the lube oil filter housing. Open the lube oil filter housing drain cork so that extra lube oil can drain out into the engine lube oil sump. Then unscrew all the eye bolts of the lube oil filter housing one by one and open the cover of the lube oil filter housing. Take out the lube oil filters and let them suspend in the lube oil housing till all the lube oil in the filters have drained out. Now dispose of all the used filters and clean the lube oil filter housing with lintless cloth thoroughly. There should be no foreign material in the lube oil housing. Now fit new lube oil filters in the housing. Take out the old lube oil filter O-ring and replace with a new O-ring. Close the cover and tighten all the eye bolts properly. Now close the lube oil filter housing drain cocks and seal them with wire. In the B schedule of turbo supercharger, check the lube oil paper filter and change its element and the O-ring. Open the center bolt of the filter housing. Take the filter housing out from its holder and change its element. Renew the O-ring and refit the housing back into its holder. Tighten the center bolt properly. In the B schedule of exhaust manifold, check thoroughly the tightness of all the exhaust manifold joint bolts. In torquing schedule of the engine room, use a torque wrench and check the torquing of all the air and exhaust elbow bolts. Adjust the torque wrench at the following recommended values for each bolt. Torque the bolt connecting cap screw exhaust pipe to cylinder head at 60 foot-pounds. Torque the bolt connecting the air inlet elbow to the engine block at 75 foot-pounds. Torque the bolt connecting air elbow to cylinder head at 150 foot-pounds. And the bolt connecting the cap screw strong back to the cylinder head at 300 foot-pounds. In the B schedule of fuel oil system, renew the fuel oil filters and their gaskets. Send samples of fuel oil from fuel oil primary filter housing for lab testing. In the A schedule of expressor, open the drain plug of the compressor intercooler and drain the condensate from the intercooler tubes. In the B schedule of the expressor, first, inspect the air intake filter media. If the filter media is dirty, clean it with a solvent. Next, open the expressor discharge cap and take out the discharge valve. If the copper gasket is damaged or broken, take out the broken gasket and refit with a new copper gasket. Now refit an overhauled discharge valve. And refit the discharge valve cap. Ensure that's fully tight with a spanner. Next, drain out the expressor oil into a clean can and open the expressor crankcase cover. Now check the expressor crankcase sump visually. Is there any foreign material in it, like the broken parts of the connecting rod, split pins, bearing shell materials? If so, visually trace out the source of foreign material and take appropriate action. Clean the expressor crankcase. Spray with a recommended solvent. Then soak the solvent with a clean lintless cloth. Never use coarse cloth to clean the expressor crankcase. Now visually inspect the lube oil pump chain. If the lube oil pump chain is loose, change the lube oil pump chain. Next, remove the old relief valve and refit with an overhauled relief valve. Check the expressor lube oil stainer and clean the stainer mesh with recommended solvent. Also ensure that the orifice of lube oil needle valve stud is not obstructed. Clean it with recommended solvent. And finally, top up the expressor sump with fresh expressor lube oil up to the maximum mark on the expressor gauge glass. In the C schedule of the expressor, remove the inlet and discharge valves and refit with a cleaned or overhauled valve. Drain the condensate of the expressor green glass filter. After the condensate has been fully drained out, remove this green glass filter from its holder. Take the filter out and clean it using a recommended solvent only. This brings us to the end of this training video film module. In our next training module, we will show you the prescribed A, B and C maintenance schedules of the various assemblies in the radiator room, the air brake system and the undergear of the diesel locomotive.